What is going on, everybody? It's your boy the SLAP Train, and welcome back, guys. NeedForSpeed Rivals is here, back again on the channel. We did one of these episodes a little while ago, had a blast playing it, and I've kind of missed the game a little bit. I mean, in small, very small doses, if you will. You guys know I'm not a big Rivals fan. You know, I'm not a fan of the arcadey kind of steering and stuff like that, but it is something different. It is something new for today, and it's a perfect platform to talk a little bit about the brand new NeedForSpeed that is coming out, I believe, November this year, 2015. We're going to be getting that in our hands. Now, there's still quite a bit of time left before this game comes out, and I wanted to make a list, a community list, if you will, with you guys, pretty much of things that maybe can be added in before the game officially releases to the public. Now, who knows, man? Ghost Games may be watching this, and that is the reason why I wanted to do this, right? I wanted to get the community's input into the final product, hopefully, man. That's the plan anyways. Now, I wanted to go over my thoughts, suggestions, as well as your guys' thoughts and suggestions from Twitter. I did take to Twitter before making this video and just asking, you know, what features would you guys like to see in the upcoming NeedForSpeed that is going to be launched. Oh my god, we just repaired that though, thankfully. Now, on my list, the very top of my list, the very, very top of mine and a lot of other people's lists is manual transmission, ladies and gentlemen. Manual transmission has been told that it's not going to be in the game. I don't really know where the hell I'm going. Yes, I know, so you don't gotta honk at me, man. We're gonna go find out where the hell we're going. But manual transmission, though, is a huge part of the car culture, a huge part of the car community. I mean, when you drive manual transmission, you have a totally different feeling for your car. You know, you have kind of a sense of, I would say, ownership and the way that you drive, and you know, compared to everybody else's. I think that's what sets a lot of people apart from, you know, different vehicles, and also skill levels. You get a lot of different skill levels just by the way that you drive. Now, right here, you know, the car is just, you don't really feel that sense of ownership. You know, you can steer left and right, and that is really about it. You can pretty much hit the gas and hit your boost. But in a nutshell, though, it's not a lot, and that is the same kind of feeling that we're gonna have on the new NeedForSpeed. Now, it's been told that, what the hell? Oh my, okay. That's been happening to me every single damn time I'm on this game. It'll just pause randomly. I'm not really too sure why, but manual transmission to me is one of the biggest things. I mean, if they would change only one thing of this game, it would be manual transmission. I'd love to know your thoughts. We had a lot of Twitter comments saying, you know, manual transmission is something that needs to be in the game. And personally, you know, not just in terms of, you know, a gameplay feature, but I think in terms of marketability, I think in terms of replayability for the game, and in terms of longevity in terms of the online community. You know, there's, I mean, it's a really tough thing to say, because honestly, with no manual transmission, you know, I feel the online community, you know, not lasting too long. And, you know, I hope I eat my words. I really do, if, you know, they don't end up adding it in. But I feel, though, that the game will take a very sour turn if we cannot add manual transmission in. That's just my thoughts. I mean, I could be wrong. I feel made the game so much better. And you know, a lot of the fans from the older franchises now are going to be picking up this new NeedForSpeed. I've scanned comments on NeedForSpeed's videos, other people's videos as well too, and a lot of people said manual transmission is a deal breaker if it cannot be added in. I mean, let me know your thoughts, ladies and gentlemen. Personally, I'm picking up the game regardless, but if manual transmission is not in, it's going to be a very, very tough pill to swallow. Now, going back into this, my next option, I think would be really cool to add in here, more of a juice style option, would be pink slip races. Now, we've seen pinks get implemented before in a couple other games, like I said, and it went great. I mean, to an extent, obviously, people will rage, they will complain once they lose their car, but it's a risk that you take when playing the game for pinks, man. Same with Midnight Club, it was the same thing. you know, in the same kind of thing. But personally, I would love to see Pinks get in there. It's a huge risk to reward factor, and I think that's what NeedForSpeed is all about. And I think that would go perfect with, you know, their whole plan of the game. But that's just my thoughts, so ladies and gentlemen, just my thoughts. Now going on to the next one here, this is something that I've been thinking about myself personally for quite some time, and you know, maybe even implementing it into different games other than NeedForSpeed. But you know how CSGO, Call of Duty, they all have case openings. Now what if a racing genre game did the same thing? And you know, why can't I steer this thing, man? I hate this handling on the game, man. I absolutely hate it. But what if they changed that to a tailored part of racing game style, man? A case opening where you could get rare parts, maybe even unique and upgradable parts like we had in Underground 2, when you'd be able to do the outruns, and you know, if you hit a certain amount of outruns in your stage, you would get a unique upgrade. Now that's something that could be actually put in on its own as a feature, but just imagine case openings for a racing game. I think that would be very, very unique and creative to the franchise. You know, maybe adding in specialty bumpers, you know, customizable parts, performance parts, maybe even vinyl packages, rims, tires. Anything and everything can be put in to a case opening style. Throw in a little bit of microtransactions, no matter how much people yell and complain. Transactions are a big part of the gaming community now. You know, a lot of people that have been growing up with actual video games, people got money now, man, and they want to spend it how they do. And I think microtransactions are a big reason that a lot of games really are profitably well, you know, hence I would say EA Sports did great with that. I mean, all of their packs and all that stuff, man. Advanced Warfare, CSGO, proof is in the pudding, ladies and gentlemen. It really is. I mean, like I said, these ideas are anything from, you know, very big to very small. I mean, sky's the limit with this. As I said, the game's not out yet, so I mean, you never know what could be added in or not added in. Other things as well, too, we have kind of been confirmed that we will get, ladies and gentlemen, we will get sound systems back on the game. Now, with this, I would love to see a tier-based style like we did in Underground 2. You know, if they just mimic that, but maybe added in a lot more options, maybe some more brand names, if possible, and maybe even a sound system competition. That would be pretty damn dope. Almost like, you know, a button-pressing style where you have to hit your notes, stuff like that. I don't know, man. I'm just kind of spitting it up right now, just kind of thinking out loud, but I think that would be pretty damn cool, unique to the franchise, something different, man, something to get, you know, people amped up and hyped up from the old school NeedForSpeed. Excuse me, officer, ain't got no time for that shit right now, man. I'm in a race, man. Come on, get off me, bro. Oh, damn. Okay. Now, moving on to the next point, cops. Now, cops, we have the ability to drive as police officers. We also have the ability to run into police officers during, you know, just normal events. Personally, I would love to see the police act like they do in Midnight Club. Okay, thank you. I don't know why it keeps doing that, man, but I would love to see them act like they do in Midnight Club. You know, maybe even taking down random pedestrians across the street. And, you know, if you're ripping by them, then they're going to say, screw that, and they're going to go against, you know, the hostile people that are driving by, stuff like that. But I think it would be really neat and kind of, say, different if they did allow the officers to just pretty much act like normal drivers. You know, if you run a stoplight or if you run anything like that, they will go after you. Exactly the same as Midnight Club status. Not just seeing you and, you know, noticing you and then boom, you know, you're done. But maybe also integrate the ability to take in your rep on the street. So maybe if you are more of a heated driver, oh my god, that's frustrating. I don't know what the hell that is, man. But say if you are more of a rep driver, then maybe, you know, you'll be found a little bit easier, or, you know, cops, oh my shit, maybe cops will, you know, take it a little bit more serious when they see the same style car, take a little bit longer to investigate, maybe the color, you know, the make, the model, stuff like that. But just kind of, I mean, as I said, talking out loud about it, I would like to see the cops not just interact with you where they just want to absolutely murder you and kill you like they're doing right now, man. Have some respect for the citizens on the road, man. You know what I'm saying? It's crazy out here, man. Now, one of my biggest concerns is wheel compatibility in the game. We haven't heard anything about wheel compatibility yet. You guys know I have a full setup. I would love to see wheels get added in to use. Again, there's no shifting, which means that there's no clutch, so you would really only need gas, brake, and a steering wheel. But hopefully they do add in use of shifting. I don't even care, man. If they don't have a clutch, that's fine. But just give us the manual shifting, man. I'm not going to talk about that anymore. You guys know how my feelings are with that manual shifting. And this Aston Martin is just getting mollywopped right now. We're going to try to go back to the garage. Is that possible? So yeah, wheel compatibility would be nice to see. Also, the use of car clubs would... Oh, okay. Busted. Eh? Appreciate it, man. Appreciate it. Car clubs online, I think, would be great. Also, something to keep the game going throughout the year before they come out with another one. Or, you know, assuming that that's what's going to happen. I don't really know if they're going to be planning on making another one after this. Probably going to see how sales go. But, you know, having the use of car clubs online just brings that more kind of personalization into the game and kind of gives you more of a connection to the online community. And I think that is key this time around for any games coming out in, you know, 2015, 2016, online connectivity and, you know, just making that kind of experience better for the consumer. That, oh, okay, kick from the game. I appreciate it, man. All right, now sticking with the online experience, one thing that I thought would be really cool would be almost like a meet spot online, you know, somewhere where everybody can go park their cars, but maybe make it so you can't really leave with everybody. Now, I know that sounds weird, but hear me out though. Maybe this would give them the opportunity to throw in more vehicles into this little session. Maybe say have 30 to 50 vehicles in here online, but have it where the vehicles don't really, oh my geez, we just died. Okay. But yeah, so make it maybe, you know, say a massive 50 player lobby room where you would just leave your cars there, you know, they wouldn't be able to move, but you'd be able to get out of the vehicle and walk around, you know, maybe add a little bit of character customization involved with it as well, too. Personally, I think that would be really kind of cool, a little bit different, a little innovative as well, too, you know, maybe have the ability to also put some of those character clothings in those kind of case opening packs that we discussed a little while ago, right? I mean, it's all coming together, man. I think that'd be absolutely dope to see. Another thing that I thought of, you know, was online game modes. What are we going to see online? Are we going to see the traditional, you know, sprint, circuit, drift, you know, maybe kind of rally cross? What are we going to see? I don't know exactly, but if we're going to be seeing drifting events, it's going to be a little bit difficult to really kind of, you know, get as much angle and maybe some tandems like we're expecting with that changes of gear where it just, we have no damn control over at all. So I'm really kind of intrigued to see what's going to be coming out in terms of online stuff, maybe some cops and robbers, you know, kings, stuff like that. Who knows, man, really? But sky's the limit at this point. Let me know what you guys would like to see in terms of online game modes. As I said, you never know who could be watching in the comments down below. Now, as I said, I spoke about character customization. Even if it wasn't just with, say, that online meet spot, I've yet to see a game really go in-depth with your own character customization. I would love to see that because, personally, that's what I love, man, is customization, stuff like that. So, again, would love to see that in the final product. Online replays is going to be a big thing for me as well, too. I've always stressed that no matter what game I play. Online replays, it's 2015. I feel like it's a necessity now, not just an optional feature. So I'm hoping that we do get some actual replays where we can, you know, just maybe cycle cameras. I don't know how hard it would be to just put some cameras around the city. Now, as I said, unique upgrades I think would be great to put back into the game. Something a little bit different and maybe add a little bit of a replayability factor. Again, we're only going to have 5 spots in our garage, so that's going to make our cars a lot more valuable in terms of career mode. So I think, you know, having the ability to customize a car like that and bring it online and have that kind of advantage with a unique part would be huge and would be exactly like Underground 2 days. You know what I'm saying? Everybody would love to see that, man. I mean, personally, that's my thoughts, man. That's my thoughts on that. Again, sticking with the garage, we will have 5 vehicles. I would love to see a garage customization. You know, after playing the Car Mechanic Simulator, it's something small, but I think it's something big at the same time. You know, it's kind of giving you that, say, personalization feel Oh, okay, perfect. Thank you, man. I don't know why I keep doing that, but it would just give it that extra kind of flavor to the game. You know what I'm saying? You know, maybe just have some preset spots, maybe change your toolboxes or, you know, tires, tire racks, you know, who knows, lifts, something. But give us the option to maybe customize our garage. I think that would be absolutely dope and something that really hasn't been done since Car Mechanic Sim. So, I mean, they're kind of setting the bar right now, man. You know what I'm saying? Other than that, that is pretty much my list for today. The things that were said on Twitter were pretty much manual transmissions. You know, we had David Black. I think David Blackman said manual gearboxes. We had Liam Norton said hydraulics for no reason other than to show off. I mean, personally, I feel you on the hydraulics. I'd love to see them come back into the game. Jack Bell says random events. Spice things up a bit. Keep it interesting. Not like Need for Speed, Hot Pursuit. So boring. We got a damn cop on our ass? Get out of here, sir. Oh my god, dude. Now, TJ Frain says full stancing ability and NOS. Now, of course, we will have nitrous on there. But yes, the ability to stance a car, I think, would be great. You know, maybe even make it to the fact where if you stance it too much, you can't drive because you'd be scraping everything on the road. We haven't seen a game like that come to console that has that ability to. So I would like to see, you know, just the ability to just drop a car and just, you know, if it doesn't drive, it doesn't drive. Then you got to go back to the drawing board. But who knows, man? Who knows? There was other things that were said, you know, more damn manual transmission. Spencer said that. We had Cambridge, I think it was Grammy Cambridge, said engine swaps and meets. So like I said, the meets, but he also says engine swaps would be pretty damn unique. It would be kind of cool and maybe have that as, you know, pack opening or, you know, even still have it as a unique part. Maybe swap in that big old bad V8 or something like that, or a nice old four-rotor SR20. Who knows, man? But, you know, it would just be something different and it would be definitely something cool to have. Ladies and gentlemen, other than that, that is my list for today. Leave all of your comments in the description, or sorry, in the comment section down below. Make a list, man. Make your own list in there and put as many as you would like. Sky is the limit. Little things to big things. I want to see it all, guys. I really do, and I would really love to see your creative thoughts get flowing in the comments down below. I'm going to be looking at them. As I said, we're going to try and get this video just shared around, get my thoughts. But one thing, man, if I can choose one thing, and I'd like you guys to choose one thing as well too in your comments, what one thing would you change for the game coming out or add in to the game? My thing? Manual transmission, man. Everything else, that will decimate all if we can throw, you know, manual transmission into the game, ladies and gentlemen. You know what I'm saying? Oh my god, man. This will decimate all. That would be perfect game for Need for Speed to have manual transmission. I think that would be the money maker right there as we're going into the damn thing. We're losing money right now, man. We're dying. We're dying. But I do feel that manual transmission is the money maker. And I think it will really kind of get the hardcore fans of the racing style genre games. They're just going to pass this game up, man. At least I feel anyways. You know, not having manual transmission, but the ability to tune just doesn't go hand in hand in my books. That's just my thoughts, though. I will say that the game is looking absolutely promising. You can pick it up right now on the PS4, Xbox One dashboard, as well as, I believe, Steam. All can be found on there for pre-order. Get yours while it's hot, ladies and gentlemen. You know what I'm saying? This game is going to be huge. It's going to be a game changer for the Need for Speed industry. Ghost Games have been doing some fantastic things, and it's only going to get better as the weeks progress. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you guys once again for watching today. If you did enjoy it, don't forget to slap that like button. Show me the support in the comment section down below. As well, too, you guys can follow me on Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter. All of which are found in the description box down below. Jabota Slap Train, I'm out. Peace. Ooh, shit, peace, officer. Everybody, it's your boy, the SLAPTrain, and welcome back, guys.